us if we moved everything out. Are you gonna get moved next? He's like, nope, not moving. This is my tack room. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel and to this weekend's vlog. In today's video, we are going to be transforming my tack room. It was going to be just a tack room tidy. However, I've got a little bit carried away in here and also been set a bit of a challenge by my husband because he didn't believe that I could make it organised and keep it tidy. We had a shadow on my face then. Robbo, if those of you that have followed the channel for a while will know that Robbo is very OCD and loves cleaning and tidying. Tina, not so much. So when he said to me this morning, no, you won't do that, you won't do that, it'll still be a mess again in a few days, you're just saying you're going to do it, da-da-da-da-da-da. That lit a fire in my belly to get it done. Sorry, every time I turn, we're getting shadows. New phone too, just remembered that, how exciting. Hope the quality is good. We do have blue sky, which is lovely, here in Cornwall today. I'm really surprised because it was meant to be horrific. Well, it has been horrific, hence the mud. Horrific weather all weekend. But actually, it's turned out quite bright. I'm a little delayed starting this. I did mean to start it yesterday, but got a bit carried away doing other things. So I'm starting it today, and I'm hoping I'm going to be able to complete the whole transformation in one day. Depends. Depends how much I yap and how much I just crack on with it. So I'm going to show you the before and obviously the after when it's done. The before I am a little embarrassed to show. However, as you know, I try to keep everything real on this channel. And yeah, it's been a bomb site for far too long. I think I did do a tack room tidy vlog about 6 months ago. So that probably was the last time I properly tidied it. So we'll turn the camera around. My main issue, what I want neater and tidier and cleaner. They are all pretty dirty. So I'm not actually going to be able to wash them all in one day. But my main issue is saddle pad storage. I don't like how they are there. Literally, it's a case of just grabbing what I can. And there's clean ones mixed up with dirty ones. And it's not nice. And yeah, a little bit embarrassed to show. My coats were all there and were all horrible. I've taken some inside already to wash. The rest of them are already clean. This box is just full of junk. This hopefully covered my address there. These parcels arrived and I know what's in there and I know they need to go in there. So, yep, I've got empty bottles and packaging and stuff I need to throw out. I've got tack that needs cleaning, but that's going to be a separate video in itself for Vlogmas. I think let's get started. These need washing and putting away. They're Banksy's show jumping boots. Rather than dither and spend time out there with them, I am going to take everything out and get started. It occurred to me what makes the most mess in my tack room is my feed. I always end up with chaff all over the floor. Well, generally it's Dinks. Dinks helps himself. He walks into the tack room and then makes a mess, knocks the lids off, helps himself to the chaff, and gets it everywhere. So I've decided, and I'm gonna see how it goes, to move my feed and have a separate feed store rather than have my feed in the tack room. And I'm thinking that will free up more space for more storage solutions for like saddle pads, boots, etc., etc. That's falling off. So I've decided we keep the dog's food down here already. I'm gonna bring the horse's food down here and do a bit of a trial of keeping the feed in a separate store as opposed to in the actual tack room. And then hopefully my tack room should, fingers crossed, stay cleaner and tidier and smarter. So let's stop talking about it and get doing it. Question is, do we or don't we kick you out of the tack room and make your feed room be the end stable too? Look at the mess you make in here with your mucky feet. What do we think?
Oh, just feed me for now and then decide later.
So you're hungry? Are you hungry, Puss?
I've just been trying to sort these drawers out. You know, drawers that just have like things that you might need one day in? Like these? What even are these? They are going into the garage. They're not staying here. I don't think they're for me. I think they're something to do with a hose or water or something. But yeah. Sped lovey bits, calming paste, height measurer, weight measurer. No, you don't need to go in there, thank you. No, you don't. Panning up to this cupboard, which actually isn't looking too bad. So I'm gonna leave that one for a minute, and if I get time or I've got some things to put in it, then I will reorganize it a bit. I'm pretty sure what was in the boxes that I showed earlier are some bits to go in here, so that doesn't need to be in there, mind. Yeah, it's not looking too bad at all in there, to be honest with you, so save that for later on if I have time. For now, need to get to work on the floor, because that is gonna take some scrubbing. Look who's joined me. I knew you wouldn't trust me to do it alone. He's doing the horrible job of getting all the cobwebs out. Yeah, I'm staying out here. Ugh.
Thanks, Robbie.
Puss Puss is standing his ground. He's like, I'm not being kicked out. I am staying. Look at him. Puss, have we moved everything out? Are you going to get moved next? He's like, nope, not moving. This is my tack room. That floor brushing was about to be a super satisfying time lapse and you beat me to it. Oh, you're such a quick worker, Robin. Aren't you? Yeah, you know I'll be out here till midnight if you didn't help me, don't you? So I'm happy I got freed. Lucky, lucky, lucky me. Lucky, lucky, just washing panties. Oh, you didn't slip. I need this. That's gonna come up. Everything out and the floor all washed. I am now heading to Argos because I've just done a click and collect order to get a hanging rail thing from there and some hangers, and I'm going to go in Homebase and see if I can find some items in there that will be good storage solutions. I've used and I've got in there at the moment one of those big black boxes, which is really good for like rugs and things, but I've seen them before with like a deeper lid, so I'm hoping I can find one of them in there. They were on offer when I last went there. Wish I'd picked one up then. But hopefully I will be able to get one of them. And I'm thinking like one of those drawer units or something like that, so that I can put like gloves in the top, boots in a drawer. I've got ideas in my head. It's just making them come into action. Yeah, you know what I mean. I love how I'm doing what Emily calls adulting. I'm doing it purely for my tack room, not the house. I've got loads of goodies in the van, Homebase and Argos. Storage solutions, coat hangers, all sorts. Determined to prove the husband wrong, basically. But I can do it, mind you. I've got a shelf that I'm going to need to put up, so I may need his help with that. Not sure he'll trust me with his drill.
I'm about there, but yeah. I'm level with the top.
Yeah, perfect. Take the packaging off. Okay. Ah! Well done, Robbie. I was like, it's too dark in here to film now. It's got night mode and it's got a flash on filming, so we'll see what the quality comes out like. Shelf going up there. Puss Puss has also been moved in here. And when that bed was in the tack room, you didn't use it at all, did you? And it's in here and you've gone in it straight away. Madness. He's like, turn the flash off, Mum. Obviously put that together and then hopefully that'll go here where the coats were with the numbers saddle pads underneath. Keep the saddle racks where they are. Hopefully they won't have to move. Then that, and then I've actually got access to this cupboard, because before when the feed bins were there, I couldn't even open that cupboard, could I? No. I had the vision and it's halfway there. Oh, I should have used the vision saddle pad. That would have gone just
absolutely
just right then. Blinding you. Sorry. I can't see you either, Robbie. You're camouflaged in this tag room. Right, so it goes there. And then, oh, I wonder if it'll be tall enough for dressage pads. Mind you, they shouldn't be much longer than those. Soon find out, I guess.
Hold this one up level with that, so we know
which
height is not too high. That's
about right,
isn't it? Yeah.
Is that in the right thing
with
the back?
We had
four saddle racks in
there
at one point.
It's straight.
Isn't it?
Is it straight?
Yeah. I think we'll be finishing this off tomorrow, Robbie. Or we, I say.
It's hair of the dog time.
Yeah, look at it, it's got dark. I've got to muck out yet.
Ah, that's perfect. Thank you very much, Lee.
Proper transformation.
Not going to get three in there? Well, to be fair, I probably could just put my show hats there and then keep my competition one on the worktop. Not show hats there and then put my everyday one on the worktop.
Yeah. All done outside for today. And I've just bought in a couple of saddle pads to put in the washing machine. And top tip for, ow! Oh, top tip, get your fingers out the way quicker. Top tip for anybody else who gets grief for putting their saddle pads in the wash with too many hairs on them. These little things are fab. It's called the Amaze Brush. And it's almost feels a bit like sandpaper. And it just sort of scrapes all the hairs into a pile like that, and then good old Mr. Dyson, he can get them over on them to set them up. This is the one with the actual pet attachment too, so it's got little bristles that spin around and help lift the hairs off. Just assist in stopping getting the washing machine filter full of animal hairs and getting cursed at by your other half. So I'm going to get these on because I want to make them look all neat and tidy and clean on the rail tomorrow. And then it will be a very good job done. Very rewarding and satisfying. I really should do it more frequently than just every 6 months. See you in the morning. Okay, so it's now the next day and I am so super impressed with what we did out here yesterday. I want to show you, and I know I showed snippets yesterday, but at the same time, I kind of want to get it all done and then show you at the end. Behind me, because we ran out of time, I ended up putting pretty much everything that I hadn't either cleaned or found a home for back in the van last night. So it's all there waiting patiently for me to put it in there. As I said, I'm excited because it's looking so good. So grateful that Rob did come out and help me because yeah, it would have taken me a lot longer and it took me long enough as it was. I'm really pleased with what I've done with the feed. I don't know if I showed that last night or not. I've basically put it in the end stable on a shelf. Excuse me if I sound like I'm talking funny. I've got a bit of a sore throat today. On a shelf here. And then bins down here. Puss has been moved to here. Much to his disgust. Although, look at him. He's decided it's now the best place in the world to sleep, haven't you? So much so, he's just going to show you how he coochies down. But no, we haven't got time for wasting time watching animals. I need to go and get on because I'm doing this in my lunch break today, so I've got to be super quick to get all of that organised and put nice and neatly into the tack room. I want to get a few more saddle pads washed too. I've washed six, but there's a lot more to wash. This is one of the boxes that I did have the same style of in the tack room, but I've now got a bigger version of it because they come with flat lids, and I found some in Homebase that have deeper lids so that you can basically store more in it. But they're really good because they're on wheels
as is this one. This is the one I take when we go eventing. I put all my cross country and show jumping boots in it, and then my studs go in here, and then all the boots and stuff go in there, and then you can also use it as a mounting block because it's proper sturdy and secure. And that one is from B&Q.
I've bought a load of the coats that I cleaned mish and then put on the floor out with me, because they are obviously going to go on this rail. I've got some hangers out from inside. That's where the saddle pads are all going to go. Going to try and keep these just like coloured or everyday stroke training ones. And then I'm going to put in a box like that the white or competition ones, but in the end, sable. I've already got some in there. Should have shown them a minute ago. But like I say, I'm not going to show too much till it's all done. I'm going to get on and tackle sorting all this out and finding homes for all of this. Put a couple more saddle pads in the wash, and then I will show you when it is finito. Say something meaningful, say something I don't know. I wanna know. I will say how good these hooks are as well. You get these from like B&M or Home Bargains, places like that, and they literally just screw in, so you can change your mind and take them out and put them other places without needing a man. Is that the right thing to say? Without needing, not a man, but without needing to put too much effort in. This was hooked just on that one, but it's putting a bit too much weight on it, so I thought if I put it on two, it'll just counteract the weight a little bit. Is that the word I'm looking for? Probably not going to end up using that one up there now though, because it would dangle onto that. So I can take that one back out and find another use for that one somewhere else. Anybody's umming and ahhing about buying one of these, then it's probably the best thing I have ever bought Banksy. I've had mine since 2016, and it makes the absolute world of difference to him when platting, studding, or just getting him ready before dressage and event. Chills him right out, takes the edge off, and really puts him in the zone, makes him all zen. Okay, so in here are all Banksy's Lycra, either full body suits or just the necks. I'll be honest, I didn't realise he had quite so many, but I've obviously collected them over the years. And I'm pretty sure, actually, that doesn't fit Banksy. I'm pretty sure that's a Dink size one. So they're not just Banksy's. I'm going to condense them into one bag, because that bag's a bit tatty. Keep them in there, and probably hook these on one of those red hooks too, or in that box maybe. I'm not really 100% sure yet. Like I said, when there's so much space, you're a bit like, got too much room, why don't I put it all? They fit nice and snug in there. So these boots are all nice and clean. Oh, thought one was missing then. And I think I'm going to put that in one of those plastic drawers. That's the Woofwear Ultraviolet. Oh, I was going to put gloves in one of those. I think gloves should be able to go in that one. So, or should I put the boots in here? Yeah, I think I'm going to put the boots in there, but it needs a bit of a wipe out. It's a bit grubby. Might not have actually needed the one with the bigger lid, but oh well. At least there's room in there should I need to squidge any more in. But so far, it's looking like I'm nearly done. Oh, just put in spare hat silks and fly veils in there. Spare stirrup leathers, lunging thingy in there. Oh, haven't done my gloves yet. Well, they can start. White gloves in there. They are odd. I need to find the matching pairs of them. That's the Woofwear winter glove, and that's the Woofwear waterproof glove. That one's just pull on, and that one's got Velcro. And that one's brand new, so the other partner to it should be here somewhere. Then I put my waterproof trousers in there, spare warm hat. In fact, Might put that cap in there. And we've got a hat of each style then. And I'm pretty much, it's nearly empty, look. Eek, oh, there we go. There's that glove and that one and two more odd ones. Also, that was in the old one whilst clearing it out, came across my stopwatch, which should not be in there. So we'll be going, ooh, that needs cleaning. We'll be going in my cross country hat bag because we don't want to get to cross country next year and find we don't have the stopwatch, do we? More hat silks, cross country one, and gloves found while switching round. So gloves in there, take them out of there, put that hat back in there. Hat silk, they're gonna live in there. Just found Dinks and Banks fly masks. Realised they're not gonna be needed till next year, so they are being stored in one of the boxes. Well, I put them in a fresh bag and then they're going in one of the boxes in the end stable. And then I think I am pretty much done. Need to grab a couple more saddle pads from inside and some, I actually need to go and get more hangers, but I'm not gonna have time to do that today because like I said, I'm in a rush. I'm doing this on my lunch break. Yeah, so that might be grab them this evening and hang the last few clean saddle pads up tomorrow. And yeah, maybe I'll show you the finished look tomorrow then because I'm not gonna have time to completely finish it today. But I'm really pleased. I'm going to open the boxes quickly and then it'll be time for me to get back inside. But I'm really pleased with what I've done so far and yeah, made so much room and so much more storage. Look. So pleased. Eek. So rewarding. Literally. Right. One box is already open because I did have to grab something out of it the other day. But let's get the rest out. Whoa, nearly dropped it. Spilt white things everywhere. Ugh. It's coming out the bottom of the box because I left it in the wet. Silly me. Oh no. Well, there's a sneak peek at what's in there. Warming wash. So this is a delivery from NAF. Majority of you probably already know that I am kindly supported by NAF. So they have sent some goodies so that the boys can have a nice bath. We've got the warming wash, which is for Banks. And then we've got this one, which is for Dinks. Pimp my pony, because he's going to be having a makeover any day soon. And we also have some tack conditioner, cleanse and condition. That's nice. It's in a spray. I like it when they're in a spray. Balsam. Used this before and it smells divine. But I don't actually need to open that one yet, so I'm gonna leave it sealed. Refill for my silky mane and tail. That's good timing because, oh no, there is, it's about half full, but good that you can get them in refills and you don't have to get the complete new bottle every time with the new sprayers. Leather food, ooh. Moisture attack with this luxurious, well, that's come in good timing because as I keep saying, I am gonna do a complete tack cleaning video. Oh, top up for Banksy's respiratory boost. Now, again, the same as the refills. This does come as refills, but Robbie threw my original one out, which is this. And I always pour the refill into this, and then I've got this to gauge how much I'm giving him. But because it was low and I hadn't topped it up with my refill, Robbie threw that out. Because as I always say, he's OCD and loves tidying. And he got there before me. So I had to ask very nicely for a replacement. What does this come in? 1 litre supply. I would take that down to the feed store, which is where I will be keeping it now, because the other one is, I believe, 5 litres. It works out a lot more cost effective if you buy it in the larger quantity. Let's see. Yeah, 5 litres. So normally I would use that to fill that up. So that can go there. Right, that's it from me. I need to clear up those white, bobbly, messy bits. And I will give you a final tour tomorrow because, as I say, I have got to get back in and get on with my work. So it's now Tuesday lunchtime. I knew it would be a few day job, this. And I'm now pretty much done. I'm just carrying out the final bits that I've washed, which are his show jumping boots, his cross country boots, and his ocean overreach boots,
and gonna store them away, and then I will give you a final tour of everything that I've done. As you can tell, I've gone all high pitched and squeaky because I'm super proud of myself. I'm so pleased with what a transformation we have made. I say we. Robbie only really helped me on the first day, like cleaning and moving things. I've decided where to store and put everything. I mean, I guess I should, it's my chat room. But yeah, let's put these in where I'm going to and then show you. Like I said, this is the box I take eventing. I won't use, I mean, the Overreach boots I will, hence they're separate, but I won't use these things until next year now, so they can go in there. Where's the lid? Oh, under there, right, need two hands. Pop these in here with their matchy matchy boots. You'll be surprised, guys, I don't actually have that many sets. I did have turquoise, but they got all a bit old. I'd had them about 4 years and they're a bit old and faded, so I now only have the UV and the ocean, and then obviously all my white ones and the ones that I've just put in there for competing. So I don't actually have that many pairs of boots, you know. I have the reflective ones that I wear all the time for hacking, and then just a couple of matchy sets. Oh, let's push that back in there. So shall we do final tour of Finito tack room? So we have the finished article transformation, you know what I mean. We have my coats, we have my high vis, we have my whips, we have my saddle pads. I will admit a couple are still in the wash, the powder blue and one other colour still in the wash, but we've got the UV, we've got the ocean, we've got the turquoise, we've got the mint, we've got the navy, we've got the orange, and then we've got another couple of different branded ones, blue chip one, free jump one, NAF one, treehouse one, blue chip one, and then we've got more white ones, but they're all down in the end stable. Yeah, not as many as I thought, actually. I thought I had more saddle pads than that too. We have, oh, this arrived yesterday. I completely forgot that it was coming, if I'm honest. This is, I didn't even know they did them. I've always used Micklem bridles and they do a Micklem breastplate. So the lovely people at Red Mills have kindly sent it out for me to trial. It's navy and it's brown, so it's obviously to match our jumping bridle, which for some reason is sat under the dressage saddle, not the jumping saddle. Quickly swap them round. Lovely and padded navy elastic, which is what we like. We know I have a thing about navy. Silver brassware and a nice grab handle. That's what I liked about it when I saw it in the pictures. I saw that obviously that goes over his withers and is nice and padded, but then it's also got a handle that you can grab should you ever need to, which is a really cool concept. I don't know whether it fits him yet. I went for the cob or small SC standard, I don't know, I went for smaller anyway rather than large horse. You will see that on Banksy soon, hopefully. In here we have my boots, as I said, not that much matchy matchy. We have hats in here, waterproof trousers in here, spare cap in here. That's the fiddly drawer that's not very easy to open and close. So gloves in the next one down because we wear them all the time. Actually just bought another pair of gloves out that have been in the washing machine. They can go in there. In this one we have hat silks and fly veils in there, all nice and organized and all nice and clean, I will add. And then in the bottom one here we have the lunging thingy, spare lead ropes, spare stirrup levers, the dry rug mitt and boots, and some stirrup iron covers. Basically things I don't use that often in there, to be honest with you. Here we have a mat that Robbie bought and he thought it'd be a good idea to put here, but the door won't close with that there, so that won't be happening. My competition hats, cross country, dressage and show jumping. Both saddles nice and neat next to each other now, rather than one on top of each other. Both bridles hanging underneath with their matching saddles. This box, which you saw yesterday, I added that afterwards. It's my new blue chip rug, but all of Banksy's rugs, again, a theme because the majority of everything in there is navy. Onto this cupboard, which was lovely restocked yesterday with a load of NAF goodies. looking nice and neat and tidy in there. First aid kit, imperative to any tack room. Competition boots for me. Probably should have cleaned the bag off a bit, but the boots, I assure you, are clean inside. Silvermore swingsy treats, which Banks absolutely loves. Insert bit of footage here, Tina, of him trying to demolish it. Blue chip refill. Clippers. Storage that I haven't put anything in yet. Robbie's tools that he needs to put away. This is like junk cupboard, so we do still have a junk cupboard. Everybody needs a junk cupboard. Deodorant. Medical hoof boots. Purple spray, things like that. Sudocrim. Thuja cream. All sorts. That one stays shut, really. Didn't really need to open that door. Then we have Banksy's show head collar. His old breastplate. The reason I got another breastplate as well, even though it's a different style to try, is because something chewed it. Look. And it is still usable, but it doesn't look very nice, does it? I think that must have been a mouse. I didn't know mice like leather. Spare bits. Eventing box that I take with me. Grooming box. Put all my brushes and stuff in there. Not that I have a great deal, but brushes, tiger's tongue, hands or grooming gloves, mane comb, etc. Rob's wellies, my riding boots or everyday riding boots, my wellies, hoods and full body lycra suits, massage pad, shower, best shower in the world. Oh, apart from the one I use for myself, obviously. Had this 5 years. Everybody always asks me about it when I show it. Especially that head attachment too, because it's so fab, because you put the shampoo in there. Yeah, it's brilliant. I would highly recommend investing in a shower if it's something that you've been umming and ahhing about, because this is 5 years old and still working amazingly. I think I'm done. That doesn't seem like very much stuff, does it? It really, really doesn't. But it is, I think, everything I need for day-to-day riding life and more. Everyday hat, didn't show that. Martingale's there too. Like I said, head collar, spare reins. Gas for the shower. New broom Robbie bought me because he wants me to keep it neat and tidy in here. And yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it. Shame the mat won't work, but at least I can wipe my trainers off now and then. Actually, look, I could just do that, couldn't I? I tuck it under there. I can pull it out when I need it and put it back under there when I don't need it. That's a plan. Thanks, Robbie. It wasn't money wasted. I'm super pleased with how it's turned out. Yeah, I really am. Looking forward to trying this out. Hopefully it fits him. And I hope you've enjoyed the vlog, guys. As I said, we've got lots of videos coming soon because I'm going to be doing Vlogmas. I hope I manage it. I'm going to be doing every other day. Meg's doing from the second onwards and I'm going to do from the first onwards. So yeah, there'll be a video from us, guys. Every day leading up to Christmas, I have said to Emily and Lucy, if you guys want to do a video on one of my days, you're more than welcome to save me having to do every other, because I'm not entirely sure I'm going to be able to keep creating exciting content every other day, but we'll try and keep them short and sweet. But you know what I'm like, I talk for England and nothing is ever short. Hopefully it is sweet, but yeah, not that often short. On that note, let's end this vlog. Hope it has motivated and inspired you guys to maybe give your tack rooms a bit of a spruce up too. As I said, I've really enjoyed doing it actually. It was much needed. It had been needing doing for absolutely ages. Oh, one other thing. Fire extinguisher, another must have in a tack room. Right, I am going to love you and leave you now. Do like, comment and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video, guys. It does mean a lot to me. I really enjoy reading and replying to your comments. Bye-bye. See you all very soon.